So Kevin, assume you're here because of the contact with Nicholas. How did you see it from your side in the cockpit?
He attacked, you know, ran me out of road, and then, you know, on the right hander we made contact, but from how I see it, you know, there was nowhere I could really go except off the track and, you know, through the bollards, which at that point it was too late. So, you know, I think he should have given me more space, but it's too hard to say now. You have to go and see it again on television and then judge from there. But a shame, you know, we tried our best. We started last today, had a good car in one lap pace, but not as good in long run. So we struggled a little bit, but gave it our best.
And as you say, great start from you. I thought the timing screens had gone wonky, but P13, so it's a bit of a shame to then not be able to challenge for points. But do you think points were on the cards today?
No, I don't really think they were, because we had more degradation than our competitors, basically. So pace in the beginning of the stints was great, but then we dropped off massively. So on to the next one.
So Nicholas, just seeing you talking with Kevin there, how did you view the incident with Kevin from your side?
Yeah, I mean, it shook me. I haven't seen a replay yet, so it's you always have one perspective from the onboard, from in the car when you think, you know, you're not at fault for sure. I went for the move up the inside of turn one. Both went a little bit deep. And then, yeah, I was quite a bit ahead, I think, into turn two, it felt like. I felt like I left enough room, but again, I have to see the video. It's normally a place where the radius of the corner kind of squeezes and narrows. So I thought, you know, that the position was mine and the corner was mine at that point. So yeah, I need to see the replay. I definitely don't feel I'm at fault. Maybe it's racing incidents, 50-50, but I felt like the corner was mine. So I have to see the replay, but it's a shame. I mean, the pace was actually really strong for our package, for how we have been. I mean, first time I've had the same car as my teammate in a while. And I think, I was getting fed his lap times, and I seem to be quite a bit more competitive despite being in the dirty air. So it feels like my season's finally coming back on track. We changed the chassis a few races ago in Silverstone, and since then the pace is always exactly where it needs to be. Instead of being half a second, 7.5 tenths off every single session, I'm now matching him like for like. Obviously, when the car was different, there was gaps, but so I take some confidence in that going forward, that the season kind of feels like it's could kind of start now. We're just reset going into Budapest.
You said just on the fringes of the points today, how happy or satisfied are you with your race?
It was a bit frustrating to be stuck in traffic the whole race, but I think it was expected from where we started.
10th and 11th for Aston Martin, though, with the upgrade, are there positives to take from the weekend?
I think we understood the car a little bit more, but we're still lacking pace. So let's see, next week is a different track.
So Yuki, sorry to see you here early. Lap one contact with Esteban, and then was that your race run from there pretty much?
Yeah, I mean, the damage was increasing lap by lap. I can feel it clearly when I'm driving, and also I think for the collision what I had in turn 8, I think I gave enough space to Esteban. I watched back the onboard, and that was clearly there was room, and he lost the control in a bit in the entry, and he smashed into me. So far looking the race, I think the top 8 was possible. So just really shame what happened today.
But we had upgrades. You got into Q3, so there are positives to take going into Hungary, aren't there?
Yeah. Until qualifying was really good, but you know, all things counts is a race, so have to be strong back, perform similar or more in Hungary, and we'll see what's gonna happen.